just allowing space for whatever feelings you have during these crazy times. So sometimes we might feel fear, anger, anxiety, exhaustion. So just allow yourself to feel those feelings. They're all okay. And allow the inhale to make you taller and broader. And allow your exhale to let you sink down, ground down. And gather your palms to your heart center. Tuck your chin slightly just to lengthen the back of the neck and set an intention for your practice this morning. Intention in your heart, keep it with you throughout your practice today. Let the hands slowly come down to the lap, open the eyes. On an inhale, we'll take the arms up overhead. And exhale, bring your right hand down to the mat. So a mirror image of you. And we're just going to take a little side bend. So rooting down through that left hip, you can come off of your block if you are up on the block, but root down through the opposite hip and just allowing that stretch along the side of the body. Staying here, or maybe just pulling the shoulder blades towards each other to open the heart up towards the sky. And then we'll bring it all back up, bring those arms back up overhead. And then take a twist. So right hand's going to come down to the left knee, left hip behind you, and take a gaze over that back shoulder. Again, a mirror image of you, so not I'm turning to my right, but you guys are turning to your left. Bring it all back up. Exhale the hands to the heart, and then we'll take them behind you, pulling the shoulder blades towards each other. You could be up on your finger pads, but lift your heart. And you might stay here or maybe lift the hips up off the mat. So you can take the head back if that feels okay on the neck. And then we'll release it back down. Yeah, then change the cross of your leg. So put in the opposite leg in front. And then we're going to take all that to the opposite side. So reaching out, right arm comes up and over. Rooting down through that left hip bone. And staying here, or maybe turning the heart towards the sky. So inhale the arm back up. And then we'll take that twist. So gazing back over the back shoulder, spine nice and tall. Inhale the arms back up. Exhale the hands to the heart. And we'll take the hands behind you again, pulling the shoulder blades towards each other, lift the heart, and maybe lift the hips. So let's come to hands and knees. So placing the shoulders over the wrists, the hips over the knees. And then from here, we're going to kickstand the left leg all the way out to the side. So you're on the big toe side of that foot. And then sinking the hips back slightly, start to walk your hands forward and let the heart melt down. So you're hugging the hands towards each other. The arms are nice and strong as you let the heart melt down. You might get the forehead to the mat. You might place your forehead on a block. Breathe. So then walk the hands back in. So they're going to be directly beneath your shoulders again. And then you're going to walk them over towards the bent knee. keeping the right hand on the mat, lift the left arm up into the sky. So turn around and face you here so you're looking like this. So stretching all along the side of the body. So then bringing it all the way back up. You stow that leg out to the side. We're going to reach down along that straight leg, and the opposite arm's coming up. Bring the hands back down to the mat. And then we'll take the opposite leg out. So extending the right leg out. You're starting with the hands under the shoulders, and then you're going to walk the hands forward, sinking the hips back, and let the heart melt down. So again, maybe the forehead comes to the mat. And walking the hands back in, so the hands are beneath your shoulders. And then we'll walk them over towards the bent knee. Left hand's going to stay on the mat, right arm lifts. Turn around for you. Right arm lifts, and then we'll take that up and over. So lift up through the hip. Let's bring it all the way back up. And then slide the hand down the extended leg. Up overhead, take the hands down to the mat, back to hands and knees, and then let's just do a few cat cows here. So on an inhale, we'll drop the belly into the heart, and exhale, curve this way. Inhale, drop the belly into the heart, and exhale, curve this way. Bring it back to a neutral spine. Take the knees wide and the toes together. Slide the hips back to a child's pose. So let's make this a nice strong child's pose. So reach back through the big toes, reach forward with the hands, come up onto the finger pads so that the heels of the hands lift up. Good. And then walk the fingers over to the left, begin stretching the right side of the body so you're sinking down through that right hip. Back to center, turn to the other side. Bring it back to center. Let's hop back up the hands and knees. So you're walking the knees back in so they're hip distance. Curl your toes under and lift your hips to your first downward facing dog. Pedal the feet a few times. Just taking whatever organic movement feels right here, pedaling the feet, swinging the hips, shaking the head. But just making yourself long here. So pulling the tailbone away from the heart, pull the heels away from the toes, reach back with the thighs. And find your breath. Let's just walk your feet just about 5 inches closer so that you have kind of like a shorter down bow. And you're going to put the weight, more weight in your left hand. You're going to take the right hand to the left calf or somewhere along there, the left ankle, left calf, and just kind of pull into a twist, looking underneath that left arm. And we'll take it to the other side. So right hand has a little more weight. And we'll reach back with the left hand, gazing through that right arm. Step it back to your full down dog. shifting the weight forward to a plank, we're bringing the shoulders over the wrists, reach through the heels forward with the crown, and then hug your arms towards each other. So kind of like you're trying to squeeze the mat together. So then you can drop down to your knees, we'll come all the way down to the belly. Press into the feet so the toes are pointed. You're gonna press into the feet so much so that your kneecaps lift, shoulder blades come towards each other. Inhale, we're gonna lift the chest up for a cobra, and then release back down. And inhale and back up so the legs are strong. And exhale down. One more time, inhale up. And exhale down. This time, I want you to lift your hands just about an inch up off the mat. And then we're gonna lift the legs and the chest up. So lifting everything up, the only thing that's touching is the hips, the belly. Breathe, take the hands down alongside you and reach them back. So the inner thighs roll towards the sky, the shoulder blades pull towards each other. And just think about making yourself very long here. The neck is long, so your gaze is down. Let's keep the feet lifted. We'll bring the palms back to line up with the middle ribs, and then drop the feet down, lift up for a little bit higher cobra. Curl the toes, take it back to a downward facing dog. And pedal the feet a few times. Next room here, bend your knees, look at your hands. Walk your feet all the way up to your hands. And take a big inhale, lengthen your spine. So that spine is nice and flat. You can have a little bend in your knees here if you need. And then exhale forward. Do that again. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale forward. And one more time. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale forward. And still just stay here in an Uttanasana. So taking a hold of the opposite elbows, put a little bend in your knees. Just take a sway from side to side. Let your head get heavy. And then from here, release the hands and put a bend in your knees if you don't have one. With a rounded spine, you're just going to roll up nice and slow. So your head hangs. The head is the last thing to come up. And then taking a few shoulder rolls here. So just rolling the shoulders back. This tall spine. And then bring the shoulders forward. Send back to your Tadasana. So in your Tadasana, your feet are about hip distance apart. Lift the toes, spread the toes. Kneecaps lift, crown of the head reaches up towards the sky, belly's in. On an inhale, take the arms up overhead. And then take a hold of your right wrist, reach up towards the sky, and then a little side bend over to your left. So reaching, you can jut out with that right hip. And then bring it back to center. Take a hold of the left wrist, reach it up. And a little side bend to the right. Jutting out through that left hip. Inhale it back up. Exhale your hands to your heart. So let's inhale the arms up. We'll exhale and fold. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, take your right leg back. Reach through your heart. So you're reaching through that back heel. And just making yourself nice and long here. Take a few breaths. Maybe wiggle around a little bit, just trying to work that hip open a bit. And then we'll drop the back knee down to the mat. So the knee's gonna be behind your hip. And then bringing the hands up to that left thigh. Reach the heart forward. Let's take your hands to your hips here. Reach the heart up and then just maybe a little back bend. So pulling that right hip point up towards your belly. And then taking the arms up overhead. The hands are gonna come down to the mat. We're gonna keep the right hand on the floor. Left arm reaches up for a twist. Nice So from that twist, turn the left palm to face behind you. Wrap that arm around. And take a hold, see if you can take a hold of the right hip, pulling the shoulder blades back. Hug the left knee in, so you're pressing into all four corners of that left foot. Squeezing the shoulder blades towards each other. Nice, untwist. So bring that left hand down. We're gonna pop off the back foot, or the back knee, and bring that right foot forward to meet the left. Let's take a little standing split here. So hands are on the floor. If you have blocks, you can have your hands on your blocks here. With the right inner thighs rolling up towards the sky. And then we'll bring that right foot down. Take a big inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. And take the left leg back. So reach it through, again, through the heart. Reach it forward towards the front of the mat. Maybe take a little wiggle from side to side. Drop the back knee down so it's a little bit behind the hip. Bring the hands to the right thigh. And you can kind of sink in here a little bit, getting a nice stretch in the front of the right hip. And then hands to the hips. Take a little back foot. So we're pulling that left hip up. Press the feet into the floor so the legs are nice and strong. Just bring it back. Reach those arms up overhead. Sides of the body are nice and long. You can take a little back bend here if that feels good. And then bring the hands down to the mat. Left hand stays on the floor beneath that left shoulder, right arm lifts. Right, so we'll face the right palm behind you, so the thumb's reaching towards the foot of the mat or the back of the mat, and then we'll take that arm around, wrapping it, pulling the shoulder blades towards each other. And just making sure you keep that right foot firmly planted. Bring that right hand down. We're going to pop up the back foot or the back knee and then find that standing split. So you might just walk your left foot in a bit, hands in front of you, and we're going to lift that left leg. So block could be under the hands if you need. We're curling that left inner thigh up towards the spine. Bring that left foot down and meet the right. Big inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. Press into the feet, inhale the arms up. And exhale the hands to the heart. Okay. So you should be at the front of your mat. We'll do a few sun salutations. So inhaling the arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, back to plank. So lowering down, either through a chaturanga here, or if you're not ready for that, we'll bring the knees down, lower down. Inhale up for a cobra, and exhale to downward facing dog. And three breaths here. Bend your knees, look towards your hands, walk, step, or jump your feet forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, forward. Press into the feet, inhale, the arms up. Exhale, the hands to the heart. Let's do that one more time. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, back to plank. So lowering down these chest, chin, if you're ready for a chaturanga. Inhale to an up dog, maybe a cobra, and exhale down, facing back. Okay. Bend your knees, look towards your hands, walk, step, or jump your feet forward. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, forward. Press into the feet, inhale, the arms up. Inhale the arms up, exhale fold. Inhale, lengthen the spine, exhale back to plank. Lowering down knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale to up dog or cobra, and exhale to downward facing. So
So your next inhale, reach the right leg up into the air. Reaching back through the heel, toes point down, inner thighs squeeze towards each other. And then from here, we're going to bring that right foot between your hands. Take the hands a little bit in front of that right foot and walk the left foot in. Come back to that standing split. So your hands again can be on your blocks, or maybe no blocks. But we're going to slowly lift the hands up off the floor, come to a Virabhadrasana 3. So hands can be at your heart, but we're reaching through the heel, inner thigh reaches up towards the sky. Nice. So now from here, bring the right hand down to the floor, to the block, and lift that left arm up. To Ardha Chandrasana, or half moon pose. And you can take that left arm over your head. Pressing through the left heel. Good. Then that left hand is going to come back down on the mat. We're squaring the hips. Let's take the left foot all the way to the back of the mat and step it back to the down. So here you have an option. You can go through a vinyasa if you'd like. Just stay in your down dog. Maybe you need a child's pose to rest. Next inhale, we're going to take the left leg up. And bring that foot between your hands. Hands are coming in front of that left foot, and we're going to reach that right leg up. So a standing split to start, so hands are on the floor, maybe on your blocks. And then we're going to slowly bring the hands to the heart so that the chest is more parallel to the mat. Inner thigh rolls up towards the sky. Pressing through the right heel. You can have a little bend in that standing leg too. Left hand's going to come to the floor. And right arm reaches up. Good. That right arm can reach over your head. So just try to make yourself very long here. So reaching through the heels, the crown, the hands. And then right hand comes down, square in the hips. We'll take that right foot all the way to the back of the mat. Step it back to a plank. Lowering down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale to up dog or cobra. And then exhale down, facing the mat. Breathe. Let's bend the knees, look towards the hands, walk, step, or jump the feet through. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale. Bend into the knees here. So your feet are going to be about hip distance. We're going to bend into the knees, bring the arms up for Katasana. So most of the weight is going to be in your heels. See if you can lift your toes up off the mat. So all the weight's in your heels. And then we'll bring the hands to the heart, and we're going to shift that weight so that you lift your heels and come up onto the balls of the feet. So your feet can be together or hip distance or somewhere in between there, whatever feels comfortable for you. But keep pulling the hip points up. And then let's take your hands back. Bring your hands back to your heart. Set the heels down and bring the hands forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. Step it back to plank. Lowering down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale to up dog or cobra. And exhale again, downward facing dog. Nice. So a little challenge here. We're going to reach that right leg up into the air. And from here, we're going to move right into an Ardha Chandrasana or a half moon pose. So that right foot's going to come forward. Right hand stays on the mat. Left arm reaches up. So hips are open towards the left. Maybe the left arm comes over the head. And bring that left hand down to the mat. Square your hips.
take the left foot all the way to the back of the mat, step it back to it. Left leg lifts. And one sweep, one move. So we're going to bring that left foot forward. Come right into our artisan chest. On the left. So reach in through the right heel, the right hand, the crown. The right hand comes down. We'll bend into that left foot. Take that right foot all the way to the mat. On that, step back to down dog. Then let's come through a vinyasa. Bend the knees up towards the hands, walk step or jump forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, forward. Bend into the knees. Come up to an Utkatasana.
So this time, in our Utkatasana, we're just going to take a little side bend. So you're bending into the knees. We're going to reach the arms up overhead. Just like we did when we were standing, you're going to take a hold of your right wrist, reach it up towards the sky, and then take a little side bend. So that right hip can kind of jut out. I'm not your mirror image of you anymore. And we'll come back to center and take it to the other side. Get it back to center, exhale, fold.
Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. Step it back to plank. Lower down, use chest, chin, and chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale, down, facing dog. And breathe. So in your next inhale, take that right leg up into the air. Bring the foot between the hands. And you're going to pivot the left heel down to the floor. So your right heel's lined up with the arch of your left foot.
And come up to a warrior two. So reaching those arms out. Nice wide stance in your warrior two. Making the legs nice and strong. Trying to get that right thigh close to parallel to the floor. Flip your right palm, reach it towards the front of your mat, and back to reverse warrior. Back to warrior two. Bend the right elbow. You're going to bring that right forearm down to your right thigh. And let's make some room here. So press into that right shoulder, or that right forearm, so that you can get a little more space in your right waist. And then the left arm's coming up and over. And you might try and roll the heart towards the sky. So just how we did in our Utkatasana, we're going to lift that right heel up off the mat. So you're just on the ball of that right foot. Stay here with the right arm or lift it towards the front of your mat. Let that heel come down. We'll come back up to a warrior two. Bring the hands to the hips. We'll straighten the right knee. Pivot that right foot around. So all 10 toes face towards the front of the mat. Inhale. Lengthen. Exhale. Pull forward. Bring the hands down.
And so hugging the feet towards each other. Reaching the crown towards the floor. Take a big inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Pivot everything towards the front of the mat. Step it back to down dog. Come through a vinyasa here. Stay in your down dog. Maybe take a child's pose. Maybe get a drink. Yeah, next inhale, we're going to lift the left leg up. Bring that foot between your hands. Pivoting the right heel down. The left heel's lined up with the arch of the right foot. We'll come up to a warrior two.
So on your inhale, just see if you can lengthen your legs here. So press into the pinky toe side of that back foot. Maybe you can lengthen the femur away
lift it towards the front of the mat and then reverse it back. Back to warrior two. Bend your left elbow and let that forearm come to the left thigh. Again, trying to make some space in your waist here. So you're pressing into the thigh, lifting yourself up. And that right arm's coming up. And you're rolling the heart towards the sky. And then let's come up onto the ball of the front foot. You might need a little, like a shorter stance to do that, so you might pull that right foot in. But we'll come to the ball of the left foot, lifting the heel. And then maybe that forearm will come off of the thigh as you reach the arms forward. Drop the heel back down, come back up to a warrior two. Hands to the hips, straighten the left knee, and pivot around to a straddle. Face you again, but all 10 toes facing forward. This time we'll interlace the fingers, lift them up, or lift the heart, exhale, fold. So keep squeezing the shoulder blades towards each other as you fold. These hands come down to the mat, inhale, exhale, fold. And taking this into a twist, so right hand's gonna stay on the floor. Left arm's going to reach up towards the sky. And switch sides. Left hand down, right hand lifts. And bring it back down. And one more twist. So from here, keep your left hand on the floor, but we're going to thread that right hand and grab a hold of the left calf or ankle. And then that left arm's going to reach up toward the sky. So a little twist, maybe a little deeper than the first one. And switch sides. So you can take that left hand all the way over to the right calf or ankle and lift that left arm up. Right hand down. We'll inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. Pivot everything towards the front of the mat. Step it back to plank. Lower down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. We go to up dog or cobra. And then exhale down, facing dog. Let's inhale, lift the right leg up. And bring that right foot between your hands. Pivoting the left heel down. So let's take your right hand to the pinky toe side of your right foot. So you can have a block there if you want. Any level, so depends on how long your arms are. But we're going to keep that right hand to the pinky toe side of your foot. Take your left hand to your left hip. And see if you can just kind of open up your heart here, pulling the shoulder blades towards each other. The right hip is tucking in. And then that left arm's going to reach up and over the head. So into a Parsvottanasana, side angle. Roll the heart towards the sky. So now bring the hands down to the big toe side of the foot, of that right foot. And just walk them out, maybe about a 45 degree angle. Kind of sink your hips back a bit. And then walk the hands back in. You're going to take the right hand back to the big pinky toe side of the foot. Left hand to left hip and start to straighten that right knee. So we're moving into a triangle pose from the bottom up. So right hand can be on the block. Maybe it's on the shin. Maybe it's on the floor. And left arm's going to reach up towards the sky. So hug the feet towards each other. Hug the thighs towards each other. Tuck that right hip in and under, and then see if you could just kind of lean back slightly with the left arm. So the legs are strong. Bend into the right knee. We'll bring the hands down to frame the right foot. Take it back to a downward.
leg's going to reach up. So bring that foot between your hands. Pivot the right heel down. Left hand's going to stay to the pinky toe side of the left foot, so block or no block. Right hand's to the right hip. And then that right arm's reaching up. Roll the heart towards the sky. And then place the hands to the big toe side of the foot. Block them out a little bit to a 45 degree angle. And just for a breath here, sink the hips back. So then we'll start to walk the hands back in. Left hand's going to come to the pinky toe side of the foot, right hand to the hip, and straighten that left knee. Start to peel the shoulders back, peel the right shoulder back, and reach that right arm up. Bring your triangle pose. So you're hugging the legs towards each other. And almost like you're trying to pull your left ribs forward, your right ribs back, and take that right arm back. Bend into the left knee, take the hands down, frame the foot. We'll step it back to plank. Lowering down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale to up dog or cobra. And exhale to down. Pedal the feet a few times. Bend the knees, look towards the hands, walk, step, or jump with the feet forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, pull. Press into the feet, inhale, the arms up. And exhale, hands to the mat. So shake out the legs a little bit. We're going to do some standing poses. So let's put the weight in the right foot to start. And take the left knee out to the side. Taking a hold of that right foot, you're going to place it maybe on the thigh, maybe on the calf, but finding your tree pose. So you're nice and tall, squeezing everything in towards the midline. Take the arms up overhead. So you're reaching the right knee back, the right hip point comes forward. So then bring the hands back down to the heart. And we're gonna do a little side bend here. So just like we did when we were in our Utkatasana, when we were standing, we're gonna slide the right hand onto the right knee. Left arm's gonna come up and a little side bend. So that left hip's gonna have to jut out a little bit to counterbalance. Side, so weight's going to go on the right foot. Take the left knee out to the side, so nice and tall. As you pull that foot in, you might find something to gaze at that doesn't move to help your balance. And you can just stay right here if you'd like. But if you want to take it further, we'll take the arms up overhead. Pulling the left knee back, left hip point forward. And hands can come to the heart, and we'll take that little side bend. So left hand's going to slide down the leg, and right arm's coming up and over. Then that right hip might jut out a bit. And when you're ready, bring it all out, shake it out. Coming back to the front of your mat. Let's inhale the arms up. Exhale forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale back to plank. Lowering down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale to up dog or cobra. And exhale to facing down. So you're back to that down dog again. Remember your intention that you set when we started. Remember your breath. So from here, let's lift the left leg up into the air. And we're going to bring it up about halfway between your hands and your feet. But take the toes out so they point out away from your mat. And you're going to come to the pinky toe side of your right foot. Moving into a side plank or Vastisthasana. So the hand is going to be in front of the shoulder a little bit, that right hand. You can take your left hand to your hip and reach that left arm up. If you'd like to take this a little bit farther, you can stack the feet and lift that left arm up. You can be down on your elbow, but lift up through the hips. And then we'll take that left hand down, come back to a downward facing dog. And all on the other side. So we'll lift the right leg up, bring that foot halfway. Toes point out to the side. Come to the pinky toe side of the left foot. Lift that right arm. So staying here, lifting up through that right hip. That left shoulders or left hand's a little bit in front of the shoulder. Maybe stack the feet. You can also have the foot like one foot in front of the other. But lifting up through the hip. Right hand comes down, back to a downward facing dog. Let's walk the hands back to the feet. Take your feet a little bit wider than your hips. And then come down into a squat. So, if you're like me, I have trouble coming into this with my heels lift up. And that's fine. You can take your mat and kind of roll it underneath your feet. Give you a little bit more support in the heels. And I do find that the wider my feet are, the easier it is for me to get my heels down. So you can kind of play with that, but we'll bring the hands to the heart, press the thighs away. So you're kind of lifting your heart here, and then take the hands away from each other. And then take a little bit of a twist. So you can have a block under your left hand if that helps. But the left hand will come to the mat, to the inside of that left foot. And then the right arm's gonna lift. Maybe wrapping that right arm back. And then switching sides. The left arm reaches. So left hand comes back down. Straighten the legs, walk the feet back to hip distance. Take a big inhale to lengthen, exhale fold. And walk yourself back to a downward facing dog. Breathe, bringing the shoulders over the wrists to a plank. Lower all the way down to your belly. Point your toes. Take your hands behind you. Interlace your fingers. Squeeze the shoulder blades towards each other. Your hip points come up towards your belly. And then lift everything that you lift. So again, just like we did in the beginning, but making yourself so long. And then maybe lifting a little. Hands come down by the middle ribs, the feet come down, lift up for a cobra, curl the toes back to a downward facing dog. Next inhale, take the right leg up into the air. Bring that foot between your hands. And drop the back knee down to the mat. You can put a little, like a blanket under that back knee if you've got knee issues. But let's walk the hands to the big toe side of that right foot. Reach the heart forward. And then start to allow the right knee to fall out.
towards the right side a little bit. So you're on the pinky toe side of that right foot. And you could stay right here or keep that left hand planted. Some of you might be able to come onto your elbow. We're going to try and bend the left knee and come back to take a hold of that left foot with the right hand and open up. So the heart opens, the shoulder blades pull towards each other. The right knee comes out to the side. Just release that. Step it back to a down dog. Nice left leg reaches. We'll bring that foot between your hands. We'll drop the back knee down. Hands come to the big toe side of the foot. Reach the heart forward. So you're staying here. Allow that left foot to fall out to the side, or the left knee to fall out to the side. Maybe bending that back knee and take it over the foot. Reach the heart. So squeeze the shoulder blades together. Like it's like a little back bend. Coming onto the big toe or the pinky toe side of that left foot. Then some of you might be on the elbow of that right foot, maybe an elbow on a block. So please take it back to the down dog. Let's come through a vinyasa here. So bringing the shoulders over the wrists to a plank. Lowering down this chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale up dog, or cobra. Exhale. So just like we did in our beginning, we're going to go back into an Ardha Chandrasana. So if you know you need a block for that, you might want to take your block to the front of your mat. Got lots of blocks here. So on your next inhale, we'll take the left leg up into the air. We're going to reach that left foot forward and find your Ardha Chandrasana. So reaching that right arm up. Now you could stay here, but since we warmed that right thigh up, you might be able to take a hold of the right foot and come into the Ardha Chandrasana. So stretching that right thigh. Pulling the shoulder blades towards each other, opening the heart. And when you're ready, we'll release it. Come back to a downward facing dog. Next inhale, reach the right leg up. Bring that foot between your hands. Come right into your Ardha Chandrasana. Block or no block. And then staying here or maybe taking a hold of that foot. So for me, I've got to bring my knee forward to get my foot. Some people can bend the knee and just take a hold of the foot that way. So if you have difficulty, it might be easier to bring the knee forward. Reaching the heart forward, squeezing the shoulder blades towards each other. Slowly release. Bring the hands down to the mat, take it back to a down dog. Let's walk the feet back to the hands. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold. And just take a little rest here. So taking a hold of opposite elbows, a little bend in the knees. Let the head hang. And maybe a little sway from side to side. Bring it back to center. Hands come down. Walk them forward. Back to a down dog. Lifting the right leg up.
and it comes to a pigeon pole, so right knee's coming towards the right wrist. And you're letting that left thigh come down to the mat. So taking this nice and slow, if it bothers your knee or your back, I'll show you an alternate pose. But if you're here, maybe try and lift up a little bit. So if this is hard on your back, bring that left knee in a little bit more so your hips are more lifted. But if not, you can get that left hip point closer to the mat and lift. These hands are going to come down. Maybe to your elbows, maybe all the way down. So if that's too much for you, you're going to be on your back like this in a figure four. Just stay here for a few more breaths. And then come back in, walking the hands back in. You're staying here or maybe bending the left knee. Right hand stays on the floor, so you're reaching back with the same hand for the same foot. So bending that left knee, bringing the left foot in. So if you're on your back, you're coming back to a downward facing dog. And then left leg reaches. Bring that left foot between your hands and to your pigeon on this side. So remember, we're going to try to lift up the chest. So that might mean that right knee needs to be a little bit closer to the hip to keep it out of your lower back. And you're ready to start to float down. Using your blocks, maybe you need to prop something under that left hip. And this side might feel different. Start to walk the hands in, keeping the left hand planted, we'll bend the right knee, reach back with the right hand, put that right foot. So I didn't say this on the other side, but try and square your shoulders more towards the front. You're on your back, you're coming back to that down dog. Just one more vinyasa. Let's walk your feet in. Come to a seat. Let's take the soles of your feet together. Just take a little rock from side to side here. Excuse me. Take your hands behind you. Lift your heart. And you might even just kind of lift your hips up to bring your hips a little closer to the feet. So you could stay here or maybe take the feet or the hands forward. We're going to fold forward, but we'll just lead with your heart. That bring the knees together, we'll come all the way down to your back. Hug your knees into your chest. And then just allow the knees to fall out to the side. So you're still holding on to them, but you're letting them fall out to the side and put a little arch in your back. Come down. You're going to cross the right thigh over the left thigh.
and then hug the knees into your chest and take a hold of your feet. So left hand to right foot, right hand to left foot. So you'll start with the hands on top of the feet, and then walk your hands around so you're holding like underneath the feet, so the palms on the sole of the foot. Excuse me. And then you can kind of play with this here. You might just hug the feet in. You might lift the chin so they're more parallel to the floor. So this is like a gomukhasana leg, but you're lying down. Your little rock. Release that. You're going to bring the left foot to the mat. So that right thigh still crossed over the left. Take your arms out to a T and allow the knees to drop over to the left. You take the left hand to the right thigh, maybe your knees to the right. Bring it all back to center. Change the cross of the leg. So the left thigh is going to cross over the right. And hug the knees in. Take a hold of the feet. So feet can be down by the hips as you hug them in, or maybe a little bit more parallel to the floor. The shins are more parallel to the floor. And going to come to the floor. Knees fall to the right, arms to the T. Move the right hand to the right thigh, gaze to the left. Hug the knees into the chest. It's like a happy baby. So take a hold of the soles of the feet. And the same action here. See if you can arch the mat. So reach the tailbone down towards the feet. And bring the soles of the feet together with the nose. And you can reach the head up towards the feet. Release everything. We're going to stretch it out. Reaching the arms up overhead, the legs long. Coming into your Shavasana. So, no more effort, no more work. Just allowing the body to get heavy. Feel the weight of the body supported by the breath. Like you can stay in your Shavasana for as long as you can. If you need to come out, we'll start to take a deep breath. Move the fingers and the toes. Let the head fall from side to side. Into the chest and squeeze. And then rock from side to side. Make your way to one side to a fetal position. And use your hands to push up to the seat. With your eyes closed, your spine. Taking a moment
here to notice how you feel after your practice. That you found some space and stillness. Gather your palms to your heart center. Remember the intention that you set. And keep that intention with you throughout your day. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste. Thank you.